Nintendo likes jumping on the bandwagon, but about 12 miles down the road when the bandwagon's been gone for a week and a half. I get it. Breath of the Wild was probably people's first open world games, but open world games existed before Breath of the Wild, you know. Farmville may not have started the trend of using stupid stamina to move your game forward, but they sure are the ones who popularized it, so I'm gonna blame them for this one. Kirby Clan Clashers is the latest in a line of games that are free to play, and then you get to a certain point and you're like, whoa, I can't move forward anymore. What's going on here? And they're like, oh, I'm sorry. You actually have to spend real world money or just play again in 15 to 17,000 hours. Most of us would rather play a $30 game, pay for it, and then just have the game and just play it whenever. This one forces you to be like, okay, play it in small chunks, buy our real world money that you might end up spending more than you would if this was an actual purchasable game on, but hey, the game is free to start. Absolutely free, unless you want to actually play the game. I was planning on doing a whole video series on all these phone games that came out that have the exact same system where you go in, it's free to start, you start the game, and then they all have this loot box system of you can unlock things with natural progression, or you can speed it up and get your loot boxes for some real world money. The Fire Emblem one I did a video on, I was gonna do one for Dragon Ball Z, there's so many of these. And that's not to say these games are bad, I played the Christ out of the Yu-Gi-Oh! One and genuinely enjoyed it all the way. More than anything, these games were made to make money. They're meant to draw you in, hold your attention, give you something that maybe you enjoy, then take it away and demand a ransom if you want to continue getting that thing that you like. This isn't a bad thing from a business point of view, but just imagine for a minute that all games were like this. You only have so much money to spend on this stuff. You'd have to pick and choose. This business strategy works. It's time-tested. Look at Battlefront 2. Everybody was outraged, but they're still playing it. They're still buying the loot crates. You know, because you work for 50 hours to earn X amount of loot crates, and then you don't get what you want, so you're just like, I'll throw a couple dollars at it, see what happens. Save some time. So they're essentially giving you a wall, and instead of letting you get around the wall or over the wall, they're like, nah, just bust through it. But busting through the wall is gonna cost you real money. Do you wanna do it? It'll save you a whole lot of time. I wish I could help you save your time by telling you not to do that and play something that's better worth your time. Instead of this Kirby game, I'd recommend Kirby and the Crystal Shards, but there's no easy way to play it these days. There's emulation, which is sketchy at best. It was on the eShop for the Wii U, if anybody still has those kicking around. Why am I giving you these alternatives? Who gives a just let me play my game, right? Well, the problem is that it's mostly aimed towards kids. Kirby is an overly cute game. The last few Kirbys have been exclusively geared towards a younger generation. And what do younger kids like to do? They like to f***ing play video games. Of course they do. They're more popular than ever these days. But with this stupid Gem Apple thing, they'll be playing their game, and then they'll hit a wall, and then they'll be like, well, I want to get around this wall. The best way to do that is to use real-world money to buy these stupid Gem Apple things to play the game. It's not fair, man. They're basically using Kirby to exploit a younger generation. That's what I'm trying to say. And with these damn loot boxes and randomized capsule-based item acquisition, like in Fire Emblem, where you get random heroes when you try to buy the thing, we're not always getting what we want, what we paid for. These kind of games aren't bad if you know what you want going into it. You're like, this sounds fun, it's a premise, I like this game concept, you know, I'm not gonna spend too much of my money on it. But then, if you get addicted to it, it becomes this downward spiral. So it could turn bad in the end. After all these games are advertised as free to start, absolutely free, until you hit a certain point. But what's ultimately more satisfying? Unlocking more in a game as you naturally progress in a game that you already paid for and never have to pay for again? Or this game where you just have to keep paying and you end up spending like 2 times as much, 3 times as much, maybe even more than what the game might actually be worth? Also, this game is boring as hell, so probably don't play it because of that.